मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू bisptrainings.com. माय नेम इज अमित एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ टू परफॉर्म करेंसी कन्वर्जन इन हाइपर फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट. द सेकंड सेशन, इन फर्स्ट सेशन ऑफ करेंसी कन्वर्जन आई ऑलरेडी टॉट यू हाउ टू परफॉर्म करेंसी कन्वर्जन यूजिंग डिफॉल्ट करेंसी कन्वर्जन मैथड. टूडे वी यूज HFM रूल्स टू परफॉर्म करेंसी कन्वर्जन. सो इन टूडे एग्जाम्पल I'm going to use a rule that is called hs.trans. Let's try to understand what does the rule consist of and what how much argument needs. So hs.trans is the name of your rule. Hs is a topmost object. Translate the currency using year to date method. Translate currency using year to date method, and this function can be used in translation rule. It the syntax called destination point of view, source point of view, rate 1 and rate 2. What is a destination point of view? Destination point of view could be combination of any account custom 1, 2, 3, 4 ICP dimension member. And if you do not specify, it takes default all valid member of the respective dimension. Source point of view. Source point of view can be combination of any dimension. And if you do not specify, if you make it blank, it takes the same as destination point of view. And rate 1 and rate 2 are basically currency exchange rates vary difference. So rate 1 minus rate 2 is the currency rate. The rate can be constant, it could be exchange rate account as well. Let's see how we are going to solve this. Today we are going to solve this example. So you see this over here, we have starting and sub translate and end sub. Starting procedure and closing procedure. Okay. Step first, we declare variable. So you see, we use dim in name of variable. There are four exchange rates we have. So in order to read the currency exchange rate, use get rate function and specify name of your account dimension which store the currency exchange rates. So in this example, we're using four currency exchange rate: average, closing currency rate, previous year average, and opening rate. And then we are writing this in a respective variable: average, closing, average, previous, and opening currency exchange rate. And then we use hs.trans to perform currency exchange. So in the first example, I'm converting currency exchange for net income using currency exchange rate called average currency exchange rate. So we are going to use this example. We use local currency as yuan, in this case Chinese yuan, and after input data into Chinese yuan, we'll convert into USD. And average date, closing rate, average P and opening rate are these four account dimension member. Let's see this. So let's see average rate, closing rate, average P and opening P rate. These are member of my account dimension member. You can see over here, they are four member of my account dimension. And the type of them are currency rate. Currency rate, all of them are currency rate type, right? Average, closing, average, previous, and average, opening rate. So we'll do this in four step. First step, I'll make my font a little bigger so that is readable. Step first, I create currency exchange rate. Currency rate, HFM rule, and then step second, I load this HFM rule. Step third, we create data grid. Create data grid to load the rule, to load currency exchange rate. And fourth step, we test currency exchange rate. So currency rate example, we load data into local currency and I'll invoke currency exchange rate and you will see into base currency. So local currency in this example, I'm going to use Chinese yuan and my base currency would be USD, right? Let's do this. So I already have a currency rate rule I created sub translate and end sub. We declare a variable dim, name of variable, and I'm reading a currency exchange rate from my average rate, right? And I'm applying translate function. Here I'm converting currency exchange rate for net income, one of my account dimension member. So in order to use account dimension member, we use a hash name of account dimension member with a currency exchange rate AVE. So this is my destination. My source is empty. It will take the same source as my destination. Right. Save this and we load into our application. So I open my VM. I open my application over here. I invoke my load section, consolidate load section, application element. Load your currency exchange rate. Browse. There's a currency exchange rate. Load it. Scan for any potential error. Look at the log file. I see zero error, zero warning. I can proceed further. And I reset this and load it again. Currency translate one. So it does simple translate net income. We would load into Chinese yuan. It will convert into USD. Step one is done. Then we create data grid to load a currency exchange rate. Step 1 and step 2 are done. We use the data grid to store the currency exchange rate. So currency exchange, we use custom dimension 1, which is flow, custom 1, which flow, which uses a from currency, and use another custom 2, which is nature over here, as two currency. From and to currency, right? So I create new data grid on a document, create new grid, data grid, and I use currency exchange rate. So in my rows and column, I use from and to. From is my flow dimension, and to is my nature, custom second dimension nature. And look at this point of view. For this, I'm going to load exchange rate, which is my actual 2009 scenario view. Entity is China, group China, and currency I use is Chinese yuan. Right? Store your currency exchange rate. And design view, go to run view. Account, I don't need it. I need account dimension for four account. Closing, average, with respect to four account dimension member. And flow is my currency type. So I go to flow. There's a predefined member list called currencies. Select currencies. That's it. Similarly, for nature also select your currency, hierarchy, and currencies. Remove this none. Your currency exchange rate data grid is ready. You can look at the design view to run view and see. So intersection seems not to be correct. We need to check what is wrong over here. I'll change the point of view as Chinese yuan. Right? And okay, so change Chinese yuan and see, this intersection should be correct now. So I store average, closing, I remove this which I got it by mistake, sales third party. Go to design view and remove the sales TP. Save and run it. Okay, let's test it and then we save it. This is my currency exchange rate for actual 2009 and this point of view, right? I already stored some numbers in the past. I'm going to remove, override this number. So for Chinese yuan to USD, my currency exchange rate is 1.1 for average, and for closing 1.2, right? Store the currency exchange rate and submit this data. Done. Now we create data grid where we are going to test it. So first I test my net income. I create new data grid I'll test my net income. So I change my account dimension for sales third party to net income, which is under my equity group, net income loss. For my quarter three period, which point of view loaded into currency exchange rate? Quarter three. So I select the same point of view. Quarter three actual 2009. Look at the run view. Put some value into local currency. I put 200. Okay, it is 200 yuan. And then I convert into USD. Change value to USD. Right click and translate. Translate 200 become 220. Why? Because my currency exchange rate is 1.2. My closing exchange rate is 1.2. Sorry, 1.1. So it become 220. 1.1. Because I use for net income, I use average exchange rate. AVE, this is my average exchange rate. 1.1. So 200 become 220. 10% more than this. Now what I do, I'll take a second part of this, which I already stored. In the second part, I'm also trying to calculate my currency exchange rate for opening balance, forex opening, and forex movement. In forex movement, I like to see the difference between my currency exchange rate of average and closing currency exchange rate. Currency exchange rate difference between average and closing. Right, so I step first, I declare variable, and I keep all the variable value over here. Declaration of variable is not mandatory because in HFM it follow VB script and it does have forward declaration. So this is not needed. I declare all variable. I retrieve my currency exchange rate using hs.getRate for average rate, closing average period and opening period. And then I see currency exchange rate. This is my source. Opening and FX opening is my target. And closing and previous year closing, it's a variance or difference. So same thing, save it and once again load to your application. Go to rules, update. I'm loading multiple times for the sake of testing. You need to create one rule where you write everything. And I load it. Now I got a new translation. And I already stored currency exchange rate 1.1, 1.2. I just need to modify this grid for testing grid and I also incorporate my custom dimension member flow, opening, closing, FX opening and FX movement. I change this from my flow dimension. So I drag and drop my flow dimension over here. And I remove this custom account dimension over here and define all these four members, opening, closing, FX opening, FX movement. Right, I'm going to input it into Chinese yuan, so change the currency to Chinese yuan. Save it. You test it and save it. Let's test it first. So I already have some number 100, 100, 100, 100. Let it be same. And after input data into Chinese yuan, I'll convert into USD. Change to USD. I already have a previous value. One way you can remove it and retype the new value is up to you. I like to remove the value and retype it again so that we can test the output is correct or not. I'll make 100 to 200 everywhere, or I make 100 to 1000, so calculation become easy for the sake of testing. Generally this input is not done by you. The FX opening movement and all will be taken from your as part of your rule. For the sake of testing, I'm putting a user input over here. So I input Chinese yuan, then I convert to USD. Okay. Right click, translate. The moment you translate, FX, let's say FX opening first. FX opening translate using it's 1200. So FX opening is taking currency exchange rate of my average currency exchange rate. 1000 become 1100. FX closing taking my currency exchange rate. FX opening is taking FX closing taking my currency exchange rate. Sorry, this closing only is taking my currency exchange rate. Default currency exchange rate 110. Let me correct over here. First, FX opening. FX opening taking currency exchange rate of closing CLO. Right? What is this value of CLO? CLO is 1.2. So 1000 become 1200. This is correct. Now let's see closing. Closing is taking default currency exchange rate, which is average. So 1000 become 1100. Now FX movement is taking the difference between the currency exchange rate of currency exchange rate different value between opening and movement, which is 100. So this is how we can perform currency exchange rate, and you can test it. We'll see the next example. We'll see how to perform currency exchange using Calculation Manager. So today I'm going to stop over here and open for your question. Should you have any question, please write to us. Our email ID is and site is bispsolutions.com. Thank you and have a great day ahead.